Doctor.
Good morning.
So on the Pfizer, 90% sounds great, but people have been skeptical about vaccines. Does this mean they tested their own vaccine? Does it go to some independent place to be tested?
Yeah, no, this is fantastic. It's finally, we have some good news to really report here. So Pfizer is a very reputable company. They partnered with a small German company that actually made the vaccine. They tried a bunch of different ones. This was the best one. 44,000 patients enrolled in this. That gives it power, and that gives you tons of safety information. Now, we haven't seen it yet, but let's presume it's going to be good. We will see all the data. Everything has to come out, and it has to go in front of an FDA advisory committee to have everything reviewed, and it will be presented publicly in the scientific literature. So it's really incredible news, because it's 90% of the people that 90% protection from the virus.
But again, how long are we, if it all goes as planned, when would the public be able to get that?
So as I said in the news release that you read, they have to follow the last patient out for at least 2 months. In the old days, we used to follow them for a year or 2 years, but now, this is a pandemic and people are dying. And so it's going to be 2 months, and they should have 10 to 20 million doses of the vaccine available by the end of this year. So it would most likely start end of December or beginning of January.
Hmm. All right. Other medical news. Children produce weaker coronavirus antibodies. What does that mean exactly?
Well, kids are really behaving very differently with this disease compared to adults. A few of them get very sick, and kids can die from this, but it's very rare compared to influenza, where kids are really at risk. So, they don't make good antibody levels right off the bat. But, kids are like designed to protect themselves from all sorts of pathogens, including COVID. So they have a really good, what they call T-cell response. It's the other side of the immune system. And they're able to handle it that way. It's just it's an interesting immunologic thing. And it's one of the reasons we need to study this disease even more.
I know we've talked about airplanes. A lot of people talking about maybe last minute trips, since, it's you can get away during the holiday season. Would you get on a packed airplane, or is it just one that's all spread out that's okay?
I wouldn't get on any airplane. I mean, we are in the, it depends where you are in the world or in the United States. Right now, the upper Midwest is a complete mess. I mean, look, our rates are over 10%. Just a month ago, they were, like 5%. Things are just out of control. Too many people, if you're sitting on an airplane or being in a restaurant or being anywhere with a group of people, the chances that somebody is there that's infectious is just too high. I think you're going to see some big restrictions coming down the road very soon. You can see what the New Yorkers have done. They are really prepared for this. They trained 4,000 people to track the disease, spent $1 billion to do this for a year. And they are tracking, they find clusters that they call the red zone, then they have the orange zone, then they have the yellow zone. So it's like surgical precision. We can't do surgical precision because there's so much here.
Yeah,
but I wouldn't travel.
All right.
If essential travel, if you have to go, you have to go.
Yeah. Viewer questions. Why don't we send self-administered test kits to everyone in a county, state, region, or state and test all during the same time? Positive people stay home for a few weeks and the virus is gone in that area. Repeat throughout the country.
Well, this is really a very good question. And, if we had enough home test kits, we could do it. We don't have enough home test kits. There's hardly any. They are approved, but first of all, you have to get the kit sent to you or pick it up, buy it or the drugstore or whatever. Then you have to do the test, and then you mail it in or drop it off someplace. And then you wait for the test to be done and you get the results back. It's not like it's an instant thing. So you miss a little bit on the time. But it's a great idea, but we don't have the capacity to do it yet.
Mm. All right, here's another question. My son is getting married in Mexico next week. Upon return to the U.S., do you recommend that we quarantine for 5 days before returning to work?
Well, quarantine for 5 days and then get a test. You forgot the test part in there.
Ah.
So he's got to have it tested 5 days after he gets back.
And then you wait for the results of the test, and that's more time.
Right.
I see.
Another, well, it depends where you have the test done. But, you know, 1 to 2 days after the test is done, but 5 days after he gets back is probably a good time to take the test.
All right, Dr. Murphy, thanks again. If you have a question for the doctor, you can put it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Thanks.